Palpatine's election to the chancellorship dominated the Holonet. It was far from a landslide victory, but he won by a wider margin than even the oddsmakers had predicted, due in part to the unexplained absence of several of his key opponents. With two Supreme Court judges and Vice Chancellor Mas Ameda presiding, he took the oath of office atop the Senate podium. In his address, he pledged to return the Republic to its former glory and to purge the Senate of corrupt practices. No one paid much attention, since every Supreme Chancellor for the past 200 years had made the same promises. Pundits, however, were quick to weigh in on what the election might mean for the immediate future. The fact that Naboo had managed to defeat the Trade Federation without the aid of mercenaries or Republic intervention had many beings wondering whether planets might follow Naboo in establishing their own militaries and challenging the power of the galactic consortiums. How might the events of Naboo shape the new Supreme Chancellor's policies toward the corporate alliance and other cartels? Would legislation regarding taxation of the free trade zones and the legality of droid armies be re-examined? Would harsher enforcement lead eventually to the cartel's secession from the Republic? And might entire systems end up joining the Exodus? With so much attention being focused on the election, stories that might otherwise have been viewed as significant escaped notice. One such story was the unexpected death of reclusive Mune financier Higo Damask. Hastily prepared obituaries contained the few facts about his life that were public knowledge, but scarcely touched on the behind-the-scenes role he had played in shaping the history of the Republic. Members of the intergalactic banking clan were refusing to release any information about the funeral or about the disposition of Damask's substantial holdings on Munalinst and dozens of other worlds. Off the record, beings remarked that the intricacies of the Mune's business concerns might take decades to unravel.